This is the foundry shop. It is a part of workshop in which we are preparing the different types of mold. So basic fundamental of the foundry shop is that we can make the mold according to the type of pattern. With the help of the pattern, we can make the different types of mold, like solid mold. Like we can make the object in the single casting, or we can make the use of split pattern, or we can make the multiple types of object with the help of multiple pattern. So basically here we are utilizing the different types of box. So box is here, it's here. So basically this is the two types of box is there. So one is cope and another is drag. So this is utilized in when we need to make the split types of object. So a split pattern. So basically basic objective of this moldings and foundry shop is to make the mold with the help of different types of pattern. So fundamental thing is that how we are making the pattern. So pattern will decide the shape of the mold. So we utilize the pattern in order to make the different types of mold. So then afterwards, with the help of the patterns, we are making the mold. Then we are pouring the molten material onto that mold, and after that we are getting the casting. Okay. Now this is the pattern in which we are making the mold. This is for the second semester. This pattern is called plumber pattern. Basically this pattern is made in the carpentry shop, and with the help of this pattern we are making the mold. You see here, there. Now this is the core print. You can see this core print, and this is the body. These two are called core print. You can see the top view here. Basically it is very very important that so whatever the pattern we are making in this carpentry shop, so we are making the different types of, giving the different types of allowance. So allowance means we can say the what happened basically when we are pouring the molten material into the mold. So there are different types of shrinkage that is taken place. So like volumetric shrinkage, you have different types of solidification shrinkage. So different types of shrinkage that is there. So in order to cope up that shrinkage, so we are giving the different types of allowance on that pattern. So to make the better pattern, it is very very important. So while we are making the mold, so for second semester we are making here plumber pattern, that is the job one. So that figure is given here. So this is the body, this is the core print. So core is essential in order to make the cavity. So in the top view you can see here this figure, this is the cavity. This is the job one which we are making. Basically two jobs we are making for the second semester, and here this is the wall bracket which we are making, and here also core print. So we are making basically placing a core here in order to make the hole, and this is the complete body, this is the base, and basically this is the ball bracket. It has a paramount application. Below that this is for fourth semester. So two types of job is there. One is called bench molding, another is machine carrier. So different types of tools which we are utilizing in the foundry shop. Like starting here, you see that this is called hard trowel. So this is used for mixing the molding sand. So basically we must need to know that what is the molding sand. So molding sand, basically this is the molding sand, which consists of basically silica sand. So we are telling it's green sand also, SiO2 XH2. This silica sand means mixed with water, and we are adding the binder in this. So binder, two types of binder is there. So there is an organic binder and inorganic binder. So organic binder we can use the linseed oil, In inorganic binder, we can use the bentonite, and another is water. So three we are mixing together in order to get the sufficient strength. Now this hard provel, it is also used for mixing that. For planing also we are utilizing this. This is the planer which we use for planing. This is the iron rammer which we are utilizing here in order to that make this this molding sand strong. We have the wooden rammer, so we are utilizing here in order to ram the mold material. This is the runner. This is the runner, which is a part of that casting which is utilizing here while the preparing the mold. This is the riser. So riser, you see here this area, there is a difference in area. So top one, it is the larger area. See the smaller one, it is. So it plays paramount importance. And this is the vent wire. This is the vent wire. This is the draw spikes. This is the lifter, we can say. During the preparing the mold, some unwanted material, if it is there inside that, so we can lift that, we can take it out. So, tempering. Now he is doing the tempering. We can see here, this is the complete molding sand. This molding sand consists of, just now I told you, that basically this is the silica sand, SiO2, XH2O. Means that is not the dry sand, it consists of silica sand with water. Then after that we are adding the binder. Two types of binder is there. One is called organic binder. So in organic binder we can use dextrin, we can use the linseed oil, or inorganic we can use the bentonite. Now water is essential, so three things are paramount importance. Now let's see, they are mixing with the help of hard provel. Then this is the iron rammer through which they are making the compact of this molding sand. It is called compactation process. So molding sand becoming compact. So that is the wooden rammer. So with the help of wooden rammer, again compacting is done. Now this is the compactation process. Now almost this has finished. Then afterwards he will use the planer. Now planer we are utilizing in order to make the surface the plane, the molding sand surface, it should be plain. Now they are utilizing the split level in order to check the surface whether it is the plane or not. Okay, we will check the surface. Now this is the molding box which we are placing on this plane surface. Then afterwards we are placing the pattern, and surrounding that we will place the molding sand in order to make the mold cavity.
से 5 pounds ज़्यादा रहेगा सर। वहाँ भिजवा नहीं दिए
the pattern. Now with the help of the wooden rammer they are placing inside the mold cavity. Now it is the process of planing so that surface should be very smooth of that molding surface. Now we are placing the molding box. Now we are sprinkle some dry sand so that it should not be a stick with that particular pattern or particular surface. Now one is runner, another is riser. Riser is the thing which is placed on the pattern. This is the riser, and that side it is runner. Now basically the whole system, it consists of one is called a sprue basin, then after that the vertical passage, that is called a sprue, then a sprue well, then afterwards we have the runner, then we have ingots, then afterward the mold cavity. Then we are basically pouring the molten material on the pouring basin. It is passing through the vertical passage screw in order to avoid the aspiration of gases. Then it is passes through the runner. Then it is going through ingots in the mold cavity. So basically there are different types of shrinkage that is taken place. So starting from, we can say liquid shrinkage, solidification shrinkage, and then solid shrinkage. So basically the liquid shrinkage and solidification shrinkage both are covered by this riser, and the solid shrinkage that is covered by the allowance which is given on the pattern. Basically this is the compactation process. We are compacting this. In order to, by doing the compacting, the strength of that molding sand that will increase. That's why we're doing the compactation process. So we are compacting with the help of wooden rammer. This molding sand, they must have high refractiveness so that they can withstand with the high temperature. Because when we are pouring the molten material, they must withstand with the high temperature. This is the process of planing.
Thank you.
receive the help of this bank wire. So basically, we are making some small holes in order to escape the different gases from the mold cavity.
Now venting process has been done. Now we can see here that riser, they are taking out, and that is runner is also they are taking out. This is the process of taking out the pattern from the molding sand. Now slightly we are applying the pressure on the pattern and we are taking out. We should not apply the more pressure, otherwise the size will be increased. This is the mold cavity. We complete. This is the cavity. This cavity is for lumber pattern. This is the sprue basin. This is the sprue basin through which we can pour the material, and it passes through the base runner. The ingots, we can say the gates, then it is going through the mold cavity. Basically, this is the core print which we are placing here. So that is basically core print box. In order to make the core print, so another core print is there. So core is essential in order to make the any hole inside the solid material. Now this is the final process.
So we will pour here inside this pouring vessel and this molten material flow through this mold cavity.
So this is very very important that the wall of the
this mold cavity, it must withstand very high temperature. It should high refractiveness. It must be the coefficient of thermal expansion. It must be sufficient,
so that the sufficient the shrinkage will not affect that casting. So three types of shrinkage already I told here. So one is during the liquidification there is a shrinkage taking place, volumetric shrinkage. Then during the solidification, complete solidification does not take place, but shrinkage is there. After that, solid shrinkage that is taken place, that is taken care by the allowance given on the pattern. And this is the final process. So here we will pour this molten material. And this riser that will be taken the shrinkage. So like solidification shrinkage and this liquidification shrinkage. Two shrinkage that is overcome by the riser. And basically here we are melting the pouring the molten material. And this is the whatever the small cavities there through which the gases will escape out. So this is the complete process.